Let's take two.
Trojans, it's so great to be here, and it's so great to come together and to be together. Now more than ever, we need this. I want to give a shout out to the Trojan Athletic Fund for hosting this event, and to all our incredible players and their families, the fans, the donors, and the staff who are joining us. Thank you, and fight on. One of the great joys for me in coming to USC has been learning about our amazing football history. The numbers speak for themselves. 11 national championships, 34 bowl victories, 6 Heisman Trophy winners, 168 first team All-Americans, 82 NFL first round draftees, and 22 academic All-Americans. Wow. And did you know, last semester, our football team recorded its highest GPA in program history. 4 players had a perfect 4.0, and 62 were above a 3.0. This event is very special because we honor our players and our incredible heritage. We also get a chance to recognize the 25th and 50th anniversary teams. And I give a big thank you to all the members of those teams for joining us tonight and for representing all the Trojans who came before us. You are in our hearts. Everyone here knows football is special, and there's no place that it's more special than at USC. Trojan football brings our Trojan family together, our alumni and students, our faculty and staff, our neighbors and our fans, and of course, the Trojan Marching Band and the Spirit Teams. The energy and excitement, it really is like no other, and I know we can't wait to do it again in person. That day will come, but for now, let's still wear our colors and let's still cheer as loud as we can, even if it's in our living rooms. Let's show everyone the spirit of our Trojan family, and let's show that spirit all season long. We have an exciting program tonight. We're going to hear from our football coaching staff and 2 of our players. They inspire me, and I know they inspire so many Trojans around the world. Fight on, and now let's turn it over to our athletic director, Mike Bone.
Thank you, Dr. Folt, for your inspiring words, and to all the members of the Trojan family who have joined us this evening to kick off the USC football season. Though this is my first salute to Troy, I can feel the tradition, passion, and spirit, and I'm proud and humbled to be the athletic director for your USC Trojans. And I would like to express gratitude to some wonderful partners who have played an integral role in our efforts to be able to play in 2020. Thank you to the university leadership for your incredible support of athletics and unwavering advocacy for all USC students. We salute our fans for your spirit and competitiveness and for the outpouring amount of love and encouragement you've shown to student athletes across all 21 sports. I am most appreciative of our dedicated staff for the commitment and sacrifices they have made each and every day to create a safe environment for our athletes to train and compete at the highest level. And lastly, thank you to the most important group, our players, for their outstanding poise and leadership and for staying game ready all year long. While 2020 has demanded the unimaginable, there has not been a challenge that our coaches, staff, and student athletes haven't faced head on. There is no family stronger than the Trojan family. And that is something that we can all take great pride in and celebrate. But now let's talk some USC football. Before we hear from our coaching staff, I'd like to acknowledge that USC's distinguished football history exists because of the hard work, determination, and the touchdowns from all of the Trojans who have come before us. It's a wonderful tradition that we honor the 25th and 50th anniversary teams each year at Salute to Troy. Thank you to all the former players from both teams for joining us tonight. And now let's hear from the captain of your 1995 USC football team, Terry Barnum.
Hello, Trojan family. My name is Terry Barnum. I'm the co-captain of the 1995 Pac-10 champion and 1996 Rose Bowl champion USC football team. And I'm honored to get a chance to come back and address you this evening and talk a little bit about our 95 team and give a message to our 2020 Trojan football team. You know, when I think back to our 1995 team, it's really the culmination of 3 years worth of building and worth of fight. Coach John Robinson came back to USC in the fall of 1993 to bring us back to glory and bring our program back to national prominence. And that 93 team started the journey, and the 94 team defeated Texas Tech in the Cotton Bowl. And so that 95 team had real high expectations. And we started off the year great, had a little bit of a bumpy road in the middle of the season, but ended up with the Pac-10 championship and ended up hosting or playing Northwestern in the Rose Bowl in 1996. And Northwestern was a Cinderella that year. They had a 10-1 season, beat Notre Dame, beat Michigan, beat Penn State. And we were supposed to be just the next big name foe to fall to them. But that was not our plan. The entire time Coach Robinson told us we were expected to lose, but we weren't going to lose. And we had a great month of preparation. I came into the game, started fast, and really kept Northwestern on their heels the entire time, led by Keyshawn Johnson, who had a record-breaking performance in that Rose Bowl and went on to be the number one overall draft pick in the NFL. We really set the tone early and ended up winning that game 41-32 to bring the Rose Bowl championship back to USC. And so when I think about the 2020 team and what's ahead of you, this has been a year unlike any other. Between the global pandemic, our social justice issues, fighting for the rights and safety of people of color, in particular Black people, you've been through a lot. And this summer has been a lot. But we have an opportunity ahead of us here to galvanize our university, to galvanize our city, to fight all on the same team, and to fight for another Pac-10, Pac-12 championship. So I say to all of you, embrace this challenge. You have an abbreviated season, only 7 games. So treat every game like it's your last. Don't leave anything in the tank. Give everything that you have. Take care of one another, both on the field and off the field. We have all the ingredients it takes to win another Pac-12 championship. But now you got to go do the work. Know that Trojan family is behind you. All of the football alums are behind you. We believe in you. And we know that you're going to bring it home this year. Fight on.
Hello, my name is Charlie Weaver. I played at the University of Southern California. I am a Trojan. I played on one of the most famous defenses in USC history called the Wild Bunch, who consisted of Tody Smith, Al Collins, Jimmy Gunn, and Willis Scott. Our coach was Coach John McKay. We had a defensive coach named Marv Gould, who got us motivated and ready to play before every game. It was so exciting to enter the Trojan Stadium and listen to the crowd and all the support that we received from the fans and the alumni. We were so thankful. I am so proud to have been a Trojan and a member of the USC Wild Bunch. Fight on, Trojan.
Thank you, Charlie and Terry, for your outstanding leadership and for being great Trojans. Next up, we will hear from our incredible coaching staff. But first, let me tell you that there isn't a more talented combination of football minds in the country than the group you are going to hear from tonight. The focus, trust, confidence, grit, and love for the game is modeled by our coaches and embodied by our players at practice each and every day. I can't wait for Trojan fans to see Todd Orlando's unstoppable defense with fundamentally strong tackling and aggressive blitzing and the electricity of Graham Harrell's offense this season. I know Graham's going to be going deep, and I'm excited to see that, and I know his team enjoys that style of play. And the success on both sides of the field starts with the leadership, integrity, and vision of our head coach. So please help me welcome the head coach of your USC Trojans, Clay Helton.
Thanks, Mike. Well, welcome, Trojan family. Thank you for being a part of this Salute to Troy virtual event. Love to give you a little bit of behind the scenes action of what has gone on since March as we lead into this season. So, you know, I want to thank our players as well as USC for all the hard work they've put in since March when we left the university and were quarantined till all the way till now when we're actually in training camp. The university did an amazing job for us March through June of supplying us the resources that we needed as a football team to keep our student athletes in one shape, but also to keep them in routine. Whether it was academic services for their classes, whether it was strength equipment to continue to train safely from home, whether it was nutritional supplements to be able to up their calories so they can keep their weight, everything that they needed, even from rehab services for those that had injuries and had surgeries in the off season, our university provided. And then I'd love to thank the student athletes because of their discipline and what they did keeping in routine. We set the all-time highest team GPA in the history of the school in spring, and that's just a credit to our academic services as well as our student athletes. And we really came back in July 6th, a matter of fact, in a great position as a team and a great mindset as a team. We entered that arena in a very awkward situation of actually having to train outside. Our building wasn't even open yet, and had the availability to build an outdoor weight room and really concentrate on our team's strength, their conditioning, their soft tissue, as well as their joints as we prepared for hopefully an upcoming season that we didn't know exactly when it was going to start. Again, credit to our coaches and our players during that time. I thought their mindset of saying, you know what, we know the mission is going to happen at some point in time. We didn't know if it was going to be in the winter, whether it was going to be next spring, whether it's fall of 21. All we knew that there was going to be an opportunity out there and we needed to prepare for it. And our guys did. They did it in a united fashion. They did it with discipline, and they did it with toughness each and every day showing up to work. And so when we got the call to be able to say, you know what, we are going to have a fall season come November 7th, our guys were ecstatic, and they were ready. And that's allowed us to get to training camp now. We had 2 weeks of basically OTAs to implement our system, and now we have 4 weeks of being able to have a physical training camp that prepares us for a great Arizona State game on November 7th on national TV, which we're excited about. So I'm going to pass it over to our assistant coaches now, and I'd like to start off with our defensive coordinator, Todd Orlando.
tight four drop. Swim on three. One, two, three, go, 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 go.
The kids have been great. They've been sponges, you know, difficult sometimes because early on when the virus set off, we lost some spring practice time, but we utilized that time in a really good manner through Zoom and really impressed with how much we've retained and how much we have in right now at this point in practice time. Well, I just think the overall effort physicality has been great for me so far. Now, we go into this, what I called a little bit of a dark place that we preached, and we're going right into the heart of it right now, and there's either going to embrace it or you're going to get shot out of it. So, you know, as today's practice, another day of full pads, another day of live situations, tackling. So we'll have a really good sense by the time we get to the scrimmage on Saturday of where we're at, especially inside. There's an internal athlete, and there's an external athlete. And right now we're spending a lot and putting a lot of emphasis on the internal athlete to make sure that when they get into bad spots during game, because it's going to happen, is they know how to respond to it. Excited about the season. Tune in. We're going to be exciting this year. Fight on.
Craig Niver, safeties coach. Excited about the direction that our safeties are going right now in fall camp, learning some accountability within the system as far as making checks and getting us aligned properly, working on the fundamentals of getting off of blocks and space tackling, which is so critical. We're heading in the right direction. Can't wait to see it on the field this fall. Yeah, the development part is huge, whether it be through fundamental drills, through film study, through practice habits, through taking care of our body off the field. All the little things add up, not just what happens between the lines, but it's all a big picture that makes up the final product on the field. I'm extremely fired up. It's been way too long. If we can get out there and get after it and run and hit somebody else in a different color jersey, fight on.
My name's Dante Williams. I'm the cornerback's coach. It's a lot of guys that are showing great flashes right now. You know, they're very, you know, much maturing right now within the defense in front of our own eyes. And I'm looking forward to what these guys are going to do this season. People forget that we only have one spring practice. And so right now this is still spring football because we're only 9 practices in. And, you know, I see the growth every day because we're asking these guys to do some things a little different than what they've done in the past. And, you know, some of these guys' names are household names, especially in the state of California, but they haven't, you know, played to their full potential yet. And maybe because we're still a young group and we're still growing together. You know, even me as a coach myself, you know, I'm getting to know these guys a lot better and they're getting to know me. So, you know, they're maturing in front of our own eyes and we're growing all together as a group. This is USC. So at USC, this is one of those places that after 3 years of playing here, you have a chance of playing in the NFL. And then after that, it's up to you what you decide to do. So the development, you know, right now is huge. And you can see the growth even from the summer to now. You know, when we got a chance to work with the guys a little bit over the summer, you can see that they're understanding the defense, they're understanding what to do, and they're understanding their bodies. The guys got stronger thanks to AA. Faster thanks to Carroll and the track, you know, team coming out here and everything else. So you can see that these guys are starting to become what we all think and know that they can be. I'm extremely excited for the season. I'm extremely excited just, you know, from the first game to the last, and, you know, for us to go out there and put the product on the field that, you know, we all anticipate here being this is USC and us being the crown jewel of the West, and we're going to take back the West. Fight on.
Vic Soto, defensive line. Really excited about this year. Excited to get to, you know, work with these guys, and honestly, we're just hungry, really hungry. A lot of these guys have had some playing time, but not have been full-year starters. So really looking forward to Marlon coming out, and he's put on a lot of weight, and he's twitchy, violent, strong. Just someone I'm looking forward to see when we go out into the Coliseum against Arizona State. You look at when we came in, we had one spring practice, and the improvement from that spring practice to now has been immense. This defense is not an easy one to get a grasp of as a defensive lineman, and across the board in our room, they've taken it in stride and are really masters of Coach Orlando's defense. Marlon, by far, you know, the leader of the group. He's soft-spoken, but what he does on the field, you know, he speaks with his actions and with his hands and striking, getting after the quarterback. Caleb Tremblay as well has been a great leader. He has been one that's picked up this defense really nicely, as well as Nick Figueroa. And all these guys, again, are just ready to be that guy. They all want to put a name and stamp on this defensive line this year. Can't wait to see the Trojans run around and smash the Sun Devils, man. I'm just excited. Fight on.
John Snyder, special teams coordinator, work with the kickers, punters, and snappers. Well, right now that we've gotten an opportunity, obviously, to get going this fall, we've had a real good experienced group of guys. Chase, who's coming back as a starting field goal kicker from last year, and Ben, who's been the starting punter last year. We got in, had a real short stint in spring, got a chance to see all those guys work a little bit, and Damon, who's done really well as a long snapper. But getting into fall, working on just some consistency, Ben has really taken off. We've made a couple adjustments here and there, and his ball skills and his consistency have started to skyrocket right now. And Chase has had a good camp so far. He's hitting the ball well, and look forward to some good promising things with him. We have Jared Parker, who's a younger kid, who's really stepped up. He's really starting to come along with his consistency. Damon is solid as a rock. He doesn't miss a beat on any snap and every snap. So really as a whole, the group is really coming together well. With Ben and the improvement of where he's come from when I first got here to where he is now, and the ability that he has, the sky is the limit for this guy. He's got a tremendous leg. He's got great range. He's got really good ball skills, ball control. And when I got here, the thing that Ben and I talked about was just his consistency and how we can make that better. And there's a few things that we just tweaked with his mechanics. He's really, really, really good at being able to transition a coaching point and putting it on the field, and has done a tremendous job with it. And I just think he's, as he continues to improve that, his consistency, his strength, his distance, hang time, and his control with his directional punting is just going really well. Really looking forward to the season, guys. Fight on.
I'm Graham Harrell, offensive coordinator and quarterback coach. It's been a fun camp so far. And we're just continuing to grow as an offense. We have a lot of experience coming back on the offensive side of the ball, and especially towards the end of the season, I felt like we really started to find our stride and do some really good things. And so I think that the most important thing for us is just to continue to improve and find ways we continue to get better, but don't try to do too much. And that's what I think that when you've been in a system, when you've had some success, you start trying to do more than just your job. And so that's what we're focused on, just doing our job and continuing to master the system. And there's no magic scheme out there. There's no magic plays that we have to make. We just have to go out there, do our job, and that's enough. You can't replace experience. And so having a year of game reps under his belt, the expectations are going to be extremely high for him. And he's he has a ton of talent. He's smart. He can throw the ball as well as about anyone I've ever been around. And so the expectation is high, and he's living up to him. He's improving. And again, his biggest challenge is going to just be do your job. Don't try to do too much. There's no secrets that we didn't tell you in the first year that all of a sudden you're going to do in the second year. There's no 2.0 to this offense. It's master 1.0, and that's what he's doing. And hopefully, that's what it looks like on the field this year. Excited about the upcoming season. Can't wait to watch our guys play. Fight on.
I'm Tim Drevnell. I'm the offensive line coach here at the University of Southern California, and I'm excited about this offensive line. The return of Elijah Vera Tucker fires me up. We felt like we have some returning guys that are older. Brett Nealon's going to lead us at the center spot. Jalen McKenzie's doing a great job during training camp right now. Liam Jimmins transferred over from defense 2 years ago. Really doing a great job. Andrew Voice is there at left guard. Look for Justin Dietich to step in there and do something really, really special. Liam Douglas is coming along. And the six young freshmen they've brought in have really impressed us. I'm really excited about this group. I'm excited about this group leading us. And I really, truly believe that the offensive line is the heartbeat of this football team. So I'm excited. And I just feel like the mindset of this football team, you can really see that the players want to lead. You can see the maturity in these players, the want to be great. And I can see that guys coaching one another, trying to help us be great, not always the coach stepping in, guys helping each other to really make things crystal clear. I'm fired up for this 2020 football season. I'm so thankful to be able to play football. It was like Christmas when I heard we had a season. And here comes those Trojans. Fight on!
John David Baker. I coach our tight ends. Extremely excited for this season. Our guys have put in a ton of work. Even when time came and they didn't think they were going to have a season, they still prepared like they're going to. Excited to see Eric Cromenhoek, Jude Wolf. They've had a great offseason. I think they've put themselves in a position to take our offense to the next step and next level. So excited for this year. It's been an improvement for our guys, another year in the system. They understand what we're trying to get accomplished day in and day out. They have an understanding how they fit within the offense. And I think you'll see that as a product on the field. They'll put themselves in a position to be successful. Extremely excited. We got a ton of guys back on the offensive side of the football. They're hungry. They're excited. They're ready to take what we did last year and build on it. So I'm ready to see it roll. Fight on.
This is Kerry Colbert, wide receiver coach, USC. Excited about this year and the wide receiver group that we have. Very talented room. Trying to build off of what we did last season and continue to grow it forward. And I'm excited to watch those guys play. We've done a great job in recruiting the right guys for this offense. You know, they're a lot of playmakers in the room. They all do things well and they all do things different. You know, it's not a one size fit all mentality. We got some big guys, we got some fast guys, we got some guys that can kind of do a little bit of both. So I look forward to kind of watching them play well together and seeing what they do on Saturdays. At the end of the day, you know, our job on offense is to score points. So we're looking for playmakers and guys that can find their way in the paint, as we like to call it. We are very excited for this opportunity to play this season. I know a lot has gone on this year, and we've dealt with a lot of adversity as a team and as a country. And we look forward to the opportunity to get out there and play. And we're ready to fight on for the Trojans.
Mike Jinks. I coach the running backs. Well, I'm excited to have a healthy room back. You know, I know it was an interesting past few months and was just thrilled to see the shape that the guys came back, well, back in late July and August. Really, I truly believe that each and one of those guys at this point could be a three-down back, and that's what I'm excited about the most. One of the things I know about Coach Hill, he's going to find a way to get playmakers the ball. And we've got some guys that are able to do some things with that ball in their hand. Moving forward, what we've asked them to do is okay. We know what they're able to do when they're catching the ball out of the backfield or on set running play. We've challenged them to understand on a certain, let's say a certain pass play, not just to know that you have an option route or a swing, but what are we doing conceptually, so that if we chose to and we had multiple backs back there, we can get into some open sets and things of that nature and really use their versatility. Excited about the season. Can't wait. Fight on.
Well, Trojan family, I hope you enjoyed listening to our coaches. And now I hope you enjoy listening to two great players, two of my favorite guys, and two of our best leaders on our football team. They're going to talk a little bit about what's going on with the team, as well as this exciting season coming up.
The energy during fall camp was great, and it really started with the defense. Defensive side of the ball, credit to their coaching staff, the new staff, they've done a great job of bringing the juice every day, and that kind of reflected on us on the offense. You know, for us to beat them, we had to bring our energy as well, and just really proud of the energy that was brought by both sides of the ball at the end of camp, and especially where we're at now. A lot of juice every day, and you know, that's something we pride ourselves on, as being the most excited team to play. The freshman class has done a great job. You know, they obviously have a kind of unorthodox way of meeting the team and getting introduced to everyone, but they've jumped in really well and like a lot of the guys. They have great character, especially that O-line room. They've improved so much in this camp and really excited for what they're going to be able to bring to us in the future. I learned a lot more about myself than I thought I would, you know. Through these times, you know, you're kind of thrown into an environment you're not expecting and seeing a lot of adversity, but, you know, I think I feel like I know myself a lot better than I did in years prior, and you're just really getting to give yourself those opportunities to learn and grow, and that's all you can really, really do in those situations. Just looking forward to getting the opportunity to play someone else. You know, I love our guys, I love our defense, but I'm ready to see some other defense and see some other guys and compete against someone else, and I think we'll do a great job. I'm really excited to see what they'll do against other offenses too. Next up is the best receiver in the country, Amon-Ra St. Brown.
Thanks, Keaton. So the energy was really good during camp. A lot of guys were out there excited to be back out there, you know, from being away from the game for so long with COVID. I was just excited, you know, playing ball, being able to catch the ball, tackle, run, hit. My favorite moment during camp had to have been the first day of pads. That's always the most exciting day. You know, it's been a year since we all got to hit again, so to put on the pads, on the hit, run and hit, finally get some live actions, that was probably the, you know, the most exciting day of camp for me. COVID has been a very tough time for a lot of us. You know, we haven't really experienced anything like this before. And, you know, during COVID, I really got a chance to sit back, be with my family, and really, you know, analyze things. And the thing that I took away from COVID is, you know, that was a time for me to really work on things that, you know, I didn't really always have time to work on when I was here at school. Maybe, you know, specific things in football, maybe schoolwork, maybe, you know, relationships-wise. So for me, it was a time to sit back, analyze, and get to work on little things that, you know, I don't always get to work on when I'm here at school. The thing I'm looking forward to most this season is finally getting back on the field with my guys, being able to compete. And, I mean, our goal is to win a national championship, and we want to go out there and win every game. So I'm excited for the opportunity to go out there every week and hopefully win every game.
Hey, everyone. Rob Stone. You don't need an introduction to these two cats, Reggie Bush and Matt Leinart, here inside our Fox Sports studios. And, well, we cannot wait to be at the Coliseum next Saturday, November 7th. Big noon kickoff will be on site before you guys open up with Arizona State. We hope everyone is enjoying this year's special virtual salute to Troy. You know about the salute to Troy, man.
Yeah, it's a great event. It really kind of starts the kickoff of the season. You got the song girls, the band, the alumni, former players come up and speak. So it's a really cool event to get through training camp and get the start of the season.
When are you guys going to be honored? Should be on the clock.
Very
right?
soon. Very
one
soon
of the years we'll we were there, they honored one of the former national championship teams, Paul McDonald, a former left-handed quarterback. So at some point,
it's
maybe.
Due.
We got some more championships to honor.
We're talking football, man. Yeah. Finally, we're talking football. There's a lot of people who didn't think the Pac-12 and USC would be on the field this year, but they are. And they've got a shot, Reg, not just in the Pac-12, but they got a shot to get themselves in the college football playoffs now.
They do, and I'm excited for that first game against Arizona State. That's going to be a big one. I'm so excited that the Pac-12 is back playing football, man. Keaton Slovis, it's going to be a great year for him.
Great offense. Todd Orlando takes over the defense. They should be much improved. It's going to be a fun slate in the Pac-12.
Yeah. Did Matt just talk defense?
He did.
You talked Slovis, and he talked defense.
What is going on right now?
Change your spots right now. Hey, all of us at Fox Sports, really excited and thrilled to be part of Fox's Big Noon Kickoff on the road at the Coliseum next week as you guys take on Arizona State. We hope you'll tune in starting 7 a.m. Pacific. Ooh,
that's early.
Bloody Marys. Bloody Marys. Bloody Mary
somewhere.
Time. Kickoff coming your way, 9 a.m. Pacific, right here on Fox, where you can enjoy the Pac-12 all season long.
Thank you, guys. Really appreciate that. Well, Trojan family, thank you for being with us today. We look forward to November 7th being in the Coliseum. We wish you could be there. We know you're going to be cheering from home. Thank you for all the support that you're going to give us this season. We look forward to representing the Trojan family on our quest to a conference title and hopefully a college football playoff. Thanks for being with us today. Fight on.